Okay, so everybody asks me how I make my khao sway. I can't seem to write it down. So anyone who's following me right now, could you just kind of take a look at this? So I liquidized 3 medium onions and I added 1 teaspoon red chili, 1 teaspoon turmeric, 1 teaspoon garlic and 1 teaspoon ginger with a little bit of oil, and I'm just sauteing it. I've added a teaspoon of salt and this is what the mixture looks like. So there's going to be about 1 kg of chicken, 2.2 pounds. I'm just going to dice it up into small pieces, bite size, really, really small pieces, and then I'll show you. That's the size of chicken you're looking for. Look at that. A little bigger than your thumbnail. I'm done chopping the chicken. That's what a kg looks like. And put it in the mixture. In the meantime, I put water up for the noodles to boil, and I've hard boiling these 3 eggs. 1.5 packets of egg noodles is good enough for this amount of khao sway. Cover the chicken for about 5 to 10 minutes, it'll be ready, and then we can saute it with the next ingredient. The chicken is ready. Oh god, it's really steaming up the screen. And I'm gonna add in powdered chana, or you could use 1 cup besan, but I like to use chana powder, which is besan. Please excuse the steam. Just mix the chana powder, lower the flame, and I'll tell you what to do next. I know this is totally out of sequence, but I just wanted to show you the condiments that go along with khao sway. Cucumber, green chilies, boiled eggs, spring onions, lemon, and coriander. And I've already prepared the noodles. These are the next ingredients that go into khao sway after you put in your chana powder. I like to use a little bit of coconut milk powder and a little bit of coconut cream. 1 can of coconut cream and about 125 grams of the powder. I'm going to see if I need a little more later, but this is what I'm starting with. Also, a lot of Burmese people use fish sauce. I don't. I ended up adding about a liter of water and I'm just waiting for it to boil. And I also put in half a teaspoon more of salt. So in all, I've put 1.5 teaspoon salt. This is the last step to your khao sway. I've heated about 2-3 tablespoons of oil and I'm throwing it about 1.5 teaspoon of red chili powder. I'm going to show you what I do with it. You can't let it burn, but it has to be hot. You have to smell the spices. It smells so good. It's like a tadka, really. And there you go. And that's it. And I'm just going to show you how to make the chutney right after this. Doesn't it look good? Okay, for the chutney, you need 1 big sliced onion, 2 packets of, the super crisp peanuts. I've taken about 12 or 14 red pepper balls. And you need about at least 8 to 10 cloves of garlic and oil. Forgot to mention salt. And I'm just going to cook it or saute it till the onions and garlic turn a little golden. And then I'm going to add 1 cup of tamarind. I've already soaked the tamarind in water. I'll just show you and then I'll blend it. I put that mixture in with 1 cup tamarind paste and let's see what happens. Put it back on the fire and let the chutney float in the oil. Don't mix it. Just make sure the sides don't burn. Just don't mix the oil. Condiments, noodles, chutney, ready. And my big pot of khao sway is ready. I'm going to mix it all up in a bowl and show you. I'm going to serve it with new tea chow.